Hello and welcome to Behind the Science, where we ask challenging questions directly to the scientists who are trying to solve today's toughest problems. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. Microflow and the sensitivity gains sound great, but isn't microflow just for scientists who have limited samples? I can't inject more than a few microliters, right? And how about sample complexity? Won't these little columns just clog up? So in this episode of Behind the Science, I think it's time to get focused using microflow. Hi, Greg.
Hey, Jen, how's it going?
What a coincidence. I was just looking for you and I was looking for this system because I have an issue. I have a really complex sample that I'm running analytical scale chromatography on, but I'm just not getting the sensitivity. So I was hoping to use microflow. However, I have to inject large volumes and I heard that this system can't handle that.
Hey, good question, Jen. We actually have this tool called a trapping column, which can inject up to 50 microliters.
Really? Yeah. That's amazing. Can you show me a little more?
Sure. Trapping is pretty simple. Instead of injecting our complex sample directly on the iKey, we inject it on a larger column just in front of the iKey. We can load the sample on the trap column with a high flow so it is fast. The analyte concentrates on the trap column while unwanted components are flushed away. Once the sample is loaded on the trap column, it is directed onto the iKey for the separation and the high sensitivity analysis.
Great, so problem number one solved. I can load a lot of volume fast. However, remember I told you this was a complex sample? It's also very dirty, so my guess is it's gonna clog this small column.
Oh! I know! That's the great thing about the trap column. The larger size of the column and particle allow it to withstand very complex matrices, just like your 2.1 column, without damaging your iKey. The trapping process also washes off some of your complex matrix, such as unwanted salts, and keeps them away from your mass spectrometer. Here's an example of a real complex sample. We were looking at an intact monoclonal antibody. We needed to see very low levels of the antibody for this project. Just look at what trapping was able to do. Without trapping, injecting 20 microliters really delivers poor results with bad chromatographic peak shapes and overly complex mass spectra. With trapping, well, you can just see the difference.
Great, so trapping seems like a really nice complement to microflow.
So you don't have to feel trapped. Trapping can help you get focused.
Trapping is a really powerful technique combined with iKEMS. Flexibility, ease of use, and sensitivity are making this technique accessible to everyone. Unlock your mass spectrometry potential today with iKEMS. Check out the link below to learn more about the techniques discussed today and get information on all the chemistries available. And join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science.